Do you ever feel overwhelmed by all the footage you have for a video project to the point of not even knowing where to start? Today, we'll take a look at some of the tools in Final Cut Pro you can use to organize your footage so you know exactly what you have and where you can find it, and filter it out so you see exactly what you need when you need it. Hey guys, what's up? If you're new here, my name is Serge, and on this channel, I make videos to help take some of the intimidation out of making online video. If you find this video helpful, make sure to check out the rest of my channel, where I have tons of tutorials like this one to help you make better videos. Before you start your edit, take a bit of time to go through, review, and organize your footage. This allows you to see exactly what you have, what else you need, and when it comes time for an edit, an organized library allows you to filter out your media so only the clips you need are in front of you. First step to organize media is before you even import your files into Final Cut Pro. When you transfer your media files from your memory card to your hard drive, take a few minutes to organize it into folders. This can be as simple as having one folder for your A-roll and one for your B-roll, or as complex as having separate folders for different days of shooting, different cameras, and so on. When you import your media into Final Cut Pro, in the import window, make sure Keywords from Folders option is selected. This will add the folder names as keywords to your clips and organize your media into keyword collections. Selecting one of these will only show the clips in that folder. Next, let's take a look at what I feel is the most useful feature in organizing clips. In Final Cut Pro, you can select an entire clip or just a specific part of a clip and mark it as favorite or rejected. First, let's take a look at marking favorites. Skim over your clips in the media browser, and when you find a clip you like, select it, and from the menu bar select mark and favorite. This marks an entire clip as favorite, signified by the green line at the top of the thumbnail image. You can also favorite only a specific part of a clip. Skim over your clip and use the I and O keys to mark the start and end of your selection. Press F on your keyboard to mark the selection as favorite. Alternately, instead of using the I and O keys, you can just use your mouse to click and drag out a selection and press F to mark it as favorite. To view your marked selections, at the top of the media browser window, open the clip filtering drop-down menu and select favorites. This filters out your media and only displays the clips you marked. And if you marked multiple selections in one clip, each selection is displayed as a separate clip. To go back to seeing all your clips, from the clip filtering drop-down, you can either choose to display all clips or select the default hide rejected option. If you come across a clip or part of a clip you know you're not going to use in your project, you can reject it. Select a clip or a selection in a clip and press delete to mark it as rejected. This doesn't actually delete the clip, just hides it from the media browser. If you press Ctrl+C to display all your clips, you can see your rejected clip is still there, signified by the red line at the top of the clip thumbnail. When I record my videos, I normally record my video and audio separately and just sync them after import. This makes a new sync clip, and this is where the reject feature comes in very handy. I can reject my original clips to hide them so I don't accidentally use them while still keeping them in the media browser as the source clips for my synchronized clip. Let's go back to keyword collections. You can have Final Cut Pro make keyword collections from folder names and tags, but you can also make them manually. Select a clip in your timeline and press Command-K to bring up the keyword window. As you can see, this clip already has a keyword applied to it, but you can add as many keywords as you want. So, if we add another keyword to our clip, this clip will now show up in both keyword collections. If you have lots of clips in your library, you can speed this up by using keyword shortcuts. Press Command-K to bring up the keyword editor, and click the disclosure triangle for keyword shortcuts. Here, you can enter up to 9 keywords that are assigned to keyboard shortcuts. To add a clip to one of these keyword collections, you just select the clip and type in the assigned keyboard shortcut. Now, when you're editing your project and need to add a top-down shot, instead of searching through every clip, you just select the top-down keyword collection, and all you see is the clips you tagged for it. And last, let's take a look at smart collections in Final Cut Pro. With these, you add one or more rules to your smart collection, and Final Cut Pro filters out your clips and only displays the clips that meet your criteria. To make a smart collection, from the menu bar select File, New, and Smart Collection, or use the keyboard shortcut Option Command N. Give the smart collection a name and double click on it to set the parameters. We'll use this first one to display just still images. Click the plus button in the top right corner, select media type, and set this to stills. Just like that, we have a smart collection with only still images. Let's make another smart collection, but this time a bit more complicated. Say we want to display just the B-roll clips, only the ones filmed in 4K, and only the ones we chose as favorites. Press Option Command N to make a new smart collection, and give it a name. Double-click it to set the rules. For the first rule, we'll narrow down our clips to just B-roll. Hit the plus button, select Keywords, deselect everything, and just select B-roll. Next, let's narrow this down some more to include just the 4K clips. Hit the plus button to add another rule, select Format Info, and say the video frame size is 3840 by 2160. And last, let's narrow this down to just the clips we selected as favorites. Add another rule, select Ratings, and select Favorites. We just set up the smart collection to display only our favorite B-roll clips that were filmed in 4K. And as you can see, this was very simple to do. Investing a little bit of time into organizing your media before you start your edit, whether you keep it simple and just mark the clips you like as favorites, or dive right into it and make a bunch of smart collections, will have a huge payoff when you're editing your project. You'll know what you have for footage to work with and exactly where to find it, so time wasted looking for clips will be minimal. Do you use any of these tools for organized media in Final Cut Pro, or do you have a better system in place? I'd love to hear about it in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.